A very good morning, students. Hope you're fine and safe. Students, today we'll start with Chapter 3, Responsibilities of a Good Citizen. Now, this topic, it comes under civics. So, firstly, we'll understand what is the meaning of civics, okay? So, civics, it is the study of... So, civics is the study of human rights, duties of citizen, the governance and the environment in which our society is found. Okay, so we have discussed or we have read 4 points one by one. I'll be discussing in brief all these 4 points. So firstly, what are human rights? Now student, human rights are rights which is inherited by all the citizens, okay, and they get these rights irrespective of the nationality, irrespective of the religion they belong to, and whatever language they speak, everyone gets these rights, okay. Now some examples of these rights are freedom, education, right to education, then right to safety, right to justice, and right to equality. So these are some of the rights. If I explain this right to equality, students, then it means that everyone has the equal right, or everyone has the right to avail the equal opportunities. Okay, there should be no discrimination. So in civics, we study about human rights. Next, what we study? We study about duties of citizen. Okay. So, there are certain duties of citizen, like for example, keeping the area clean, okay, then helping others, following the rules and regulations, and abiding the law. So, there are certain duties of citizen that also comes under civics, okay. Then thirdly is the governance. Students, governance means how a group of people or a country controls or governs, right? It means that. So, for example, if we take the example of India, then how the whole country is being governed by the government or by judiciary, how it is being governed, that comes under governance, okay? How it is being controlled and how the things are being done, that comes under governance. Now students, for your better understanding, let's take the example of the current situation, right? We all know that currently there's this pandemic which is being spreading. The name of the pandemic is COVID-19 or coronavirus, right? So how our government or how our country is handling this, okay, how they're performing and how they're responding, that comes under governance, fine. Now, the fourth is the environment in which a society is found. So, obviously, the environment affects our politics and it affects everything, right? The surrounding affects us also and everything which is related to us. That is why we study the environment also in which our society is found in civics. So we have understood 4 points. Now, next move. Now, this is the next slide. Importance of studying civics. So, 4 points we have already discussed. So, we'll just revise why it is important of studying civics. First is to understand human rights. Okay, first is to understand human rights. Second is to understand the duties of citizen. What are the duties of citizen? For understanding that, we study civics. Then, the third is to understand the environment in which we live in. Fourth, we study civics to promote peace and security. Okay, we study civics to promote peace and security. Fifth, we study civics to understand and uphold culture, because while studying civics, we get to know a lot about our culture. So this way, it helps in understanding our culture better and in upholding it also. Okay, and sixthly, we study civics to establish good relationship and respect. Fine. So these are the importance of studying civics. Now, what are civic sense? We usually, you must have heard, right, that, you know, foreigners have good civic sense. In India, people don't, you know, people are very unhygienic. They don't follow civic sense, right? So you must be wondering that what are civic sense, right? So civic sense means social ethics. Social ethics. For example, like keeping roads, street, public property clean, then abiding to the law, okay, following the rules and regulations, then respect everyone, okay, respecting everyone, this is also a social ethic, and maintaining peace. Fifth, also it can be maintaining the clean environment, okay, or maintaining hygiene. So this comes under civic sense, fine. Now student, since we have already read the chapter name, what was the chapter name? Responsibilities of a good citizen. So who is a citizen? Who is a citizen? Citizen is a person who is a member of a particular country. Okay. So you are also a citizen of country India, right? Because you are a member of this country. You are a member of country India. So you are also a citizen. And citizen have rights which is being given by the government. Okay. So even you have rights which has been given by the government. So we know who citizen is now. A citizen is a member of a particular country, okay, and have rights given by the government. So students, we all should be a good citizen. See, the government is giving us the rights, right to freedom, right to education, right to equality, rights. So we are getting so many rights. So we all should be a good citizen and a responsible citizen. Now, how can we be a good citizen? There are some ways to be a good citizen. First is volunteer to be active in your community. Okay, you should always volunteer. For example, here in this image, you can see that this girl is planting a tree. Yes, and here also you can see that this boy is helping an old man. So you should always volunteer to help or to, you know, protect or keep the environment clean. So first is volunteer. Secondly, that for being a good citizen, always be honest, okay, and trustworthy, okay. So you should always be honest and you should be trustworthy. Thirdly, follow rules and laws. For example, if you are going some, you know, you are riding a bicycle and you see that now the traffic light is in red color. So you should follow the law and you should stop until unless the traffic light turns green. Then only, you know, cross the road. So you should always follow rules and laws. Fourth is, you should respect the rights of others. Okay. You should never discriminate others. Okay. You should always respect their rights. Be informed. Be informed. How to be informed? You can watch news or, you know, read newspapers to be informed. Because when you are informed, you'll be knowing what is happening around you. And when you know what is happening around you, you can respond according to that situation. So, this is the fifth way to be a good citizen. Now, sixth is, respect the property of others. Fine. So, So you should never damage the property of others, even not just the others' property, but also the public property. Like, for example, park. You should always keep the park clean and, you know, make sure that no one is damaging the plants or the other essentials which are there in the park. No one is damaging that. So you should always respect the property of others and even the public property. Seventh is, be compassionate. You should always be helpful, okay, and always be compassionate. Here in the images also you can see that this man is helping this old man and also this old lady, right? Here also you can see that, you know, this girl, both the girls are hugging each other. So you should, you know, always be compassionate. You should always be helpful and grateful to others. You should express your gratitude to others. Eighth is, take responsibility of your actions. Okay, whatever action you have done, you should always take the responsibility. Or even if you have done some mistake, accept it. And, you know, next time make sure that you don't repeat that again. So you should always take responsibility of your actions. Then ninth is, be a good neighbor. You should be a very good neighbor to become a good citizen. Also, always help your neighbors, right? And always, you know, spend time with them. Then tenth is, protect the environment. Fine. This is the last tenth way to be a good citizen. That is, protect the environment, because environment is the place where we live in. So if we protect the environment, it will ensure our survival also. Fine, students. So we have learned ways to be a good citizen. So students, with this we come to an end of the part 1 of this chapter. So we'll just quickly revise whatever we have studied today. We studied what is the meaning of civics, right? And there are 4 points. We discussed human rights, duties of citizen, the governance, and the environment in which our society is found. Then we studied the importance of studying civics. After that, what is a civic sense? Civic sense means social ethics, right? After that, we learned who is a citizen, fine? And in the end, we learn how to be a good citizen. Okay, students. So I hope that you all become a good citizen. And with this, we come to an end of the part 1. Thank you, students. Stay safe and stay healthy.